Now, the next tip for getting all of your data online, safe and secure is to use Google Photos. This is an excellent application which will allow you to store every single one of your photos online, and Google actually give you unlimited storage as long as you're okay with a little bit of optimization on your photos. Now, personally, I like to store them all in the highest quality just in case I want to, you know, enlarge mine or print it out or turn it into a wall or something like that. And I'm a bit of a purist, and so I'm happy to pay for the data plan for Google to store all of my photos in their highest quality, but there is also the free option there as well. And there's a great app for Google Photos that actually lives on your phone as well, which can synchronize all of your photos from your Apple Photos into Google Photos. And so it'll just automatically keep all of your libraries in sync. Now, one of the things that I love about Google Photos is they have their AI and machine learning built into Photos. So if I know that I've got a photo of one of my cars and I know it was taken like 3 years ago, I want to go back to that photo, I can just search for blue car inside my Google Photos and it's automatically going to find that for me as well. And one of the other things that I really love about Google Photos is, of course, because it's collaborative, I can actually collaborate and share albums and share folders with my team. And so I've got all of my business photos in my business Google Photos account. And from here, we share things like team meetups and business conferences. And you can see here, there's a photo of one of our Halloween parties where everyone is having a good time on Google Meet there. They've got all kinds of cool stuff like, you know, automatic face recognition of people. And then, you know, from there, you can automatically share people their own photos and all kinds of groovy stuff you can do in Google Photos. I don't have time to cover that, but get that one set up on your machine. Now, when you install Backup and Sync, which is the new name for Google Drive on your computer, it will actually give you the option to search your whole computer, find all of the photos on your computer, and then actually back them up into your Google Photos. So I'd strongly recommend you do that. Install Google Photos on your phone, install Google Photos on your computer, and then you've got them all backed up to Google. Now, for the person who said that they lost a laptop and lost 4 months worth of photos, this is the antidote to that kind of data loss. If you've got Google Photos automatically just backing up as soon as you hit home and hit Wi-Fi, then all of your photos are always going to be saved online and always going to be protected. So this is also a good one to install for your family members as well. All right, I'm going to break for a couple of questions here. Guys, let me know if you're loving this so far. If you're loving it so far, just type loving it in the comments. I would love that. Cool. All right, so Nissan has asked for the link. All right, I'll do that. I'm going to drop the links in here. I want to give you guys the official links to these tools just so you don't accidentally get caught with spyware or anything. So that's one. And then disk inventory, I'll chuck that in there for you as well. Cool. All right. So they are in there if you want the downloads. Annette has said she loves Google Photos. Let me know if you're loving this, guys. Cool. Don, what product do we use for cloud-to-cloud backup? That is after a conversation with our team. Have a chat to our team about that, Don, because it's actually part of our concierge program, our concierge membership. We provide that as one of the free perks for customers. So have a chat to our team about that. Cool. Loving it. Awesome. Thank you, Nissan. And thank you to everyone else who's watching. And those who are lurking, please say hello, lurkers. I see you, lurkers. Jessica has given us the love heart. Thank you so much. All right, cool. I'm going to try and get this done in the next 20, guys, so we can all get on with our evenings. We've got two more sections left to go. All right, what do we got next? We're going to cover Dropbox and Drive, and this is a big one. Okay. So let's talk about Dropbox and Google Drive. Why is it important to have this conversation? Well, because I don't believe in doubling up in business, and I don't believe in wasting money in business. Now, for many business owners, as I said earlier, they end up in subscription fatigue, and they have a hodgepodge of different applications. And for many of us, not quite understanding the full capability of Google Workspace means that we miss out on having a more integrated system and a more integrated way of doing business. Remember that Google is like the Tesla, and when we use more of Google's tools for our team, like Google Meet or Google Chat, it means that there's less friction for your team. And particularly as you grow and scale a business, as I've scaled to over 40 employees now, costs really add up when you have extra ancillary platforms and programs that are maybe not fully serving you or could be replaced with an equivalent Google tool. Now, of course, I'm speaking here to businesses that are using the Google Workspace collaboration platform, which is our strong recommendation. But if you're using something like Microsoft, then you've got a product like Google Teams, which you can use instead of Slack. And for many of us, it might be like a mix of laziness or just kind of like, I don't have the time. But we might start with Dropbox or start with Slack or start with Zoom and just not get around to actually utilizing the tools that we have available inside of Google Workspace. Now, there are other videos on our YouTube channel covering why you might choose to switch from Zoom to Google Meet and why you might choose to switch from Slack over to the Google Chat, which has basically copied every single feature of Slack now and has all the same integrations. But I want to focus in on Dropbox and talk about a number of different reasons why I choose Dropbox and why we completely got rid of it for ourselves and have done for literally hundreds and hundreds of our customers. Now, number one is security. And I'm not suggesting that Google Drive is any better encrypted or any better secured than Dropbox is. But what I am suggesting is that just having your Google file storage tied to your Google account makes the system a whole lot tighter, because when a staff member leaves the business, you don't have to worry about what files may have been link shared or what files may have been shared with an external email address or, you know, that contractor from 3 years ago that you shared a Dropbox folder with that, you know, did a cleanup on their Dropbox and deleted some files out of yours. I just like the fact that everything tied to a Google account means that you've got one account for everything. And we're now in a world of wanting to access all of our files and all of our data from all of our devices. And what that means is that we want to work from mobile. When we're in a taxi on the way to the airport, although no one's probably going to the airport all that often anymore, we want to be able to open up our files from any device and be able to get productive work done. And I know for myself personally, there's been many a time when I've been on the go, my team have sent me a proposal or a document or a slideshow, or I've snapped a photo on the street and I wanted to add that to a presentation, and I've whipped out my phone, opened up the app, and been able to do it there and then. Also, being able to access my Google Drive with everything in there is absolutely amazing. Now, for most businesses, they end up with two file systems. They have all of their Google Docs and their Googly stuff inside of Google Drive, and then all their Office and other stuff is sitting inside of something like Dropbox. Well, our suggestion is, because Google Drive can handle all of your documents and Google Drive can handle all of your Office documents, it can even open and edit your Office documents inside the Chrome browser if you wish, Google Drive is a great place to store all of your stuff. Now, Google has effectively copied pretty much every feature of Dropbox over the years and has some pretty amazing unique features that Dropbox doesn't have, which make Google Drive our clear winner in the choice between the two. Now, one of the best features of Google Drive is called shared drives. And if you were previously on what was called G Suite Basic, you may not even know that this exists. Now, basically inside my Google Drive, I not only have my My Drive, which is effectively my own version of My Documents, but I also have shared drives. And shared drives here are a space for me to set up secure folders, and I get to choose exactly who has access to those folders, what level of privilege they have, with a couple of special features. Now, one of the special features of these is you can create and turn a folder into a locked folder. And what a locked folder means is you can allow people to put files into the folder, but you can disallow them from deleting or moving or taking files out. And that's really great if you're working with a contractor, maybe someone who's outside your company and they're doing some work for you, and they are creating files and you want them to collaborate with you and your team. What we see over and over and over and over again is somebody external to a business creates a file in their My Drive, they share it just with link sharing, just by clicking the share button, which, you know, seems intuitive, but what happens is the person who created that file is the owner of that file. And so if they are owning that file in a Gmail account in their personal name, which you don't control or you don't own, they have the ability to delete that file. And we've heard so many horror stories of someone who has a Google Drive with a bunch of business data in there, but the owner is someone outside the company, and that someone outside the company does a cleanup on their Google Drive one day, they're organizing their digital life, and then poof, those files disappear from your business. And so using a solution like shared drives allows you to lock down those files and ensure that your data never, ever, ever disappears. It's just absolutely, absolutely critical, and it's one of the best new features of Google Drive.